بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. First of all, I would like to thank the board of the Egyptian Society of Organ Transplantation who gave me the chance to share in this valuable scientific conference. And I also want to extend my deepest thanks to my dear colleague, Professor Mohammed Saeed Abdelaziz, the moderator of this valuable session, who gives me the idea and the topic and the very interesting topic of this presentation. Non-liver failure indications for liver transplantation. Liver transplantation is a treatment of choice for a number of serious and life-threatening liver diseases. The list of indications of liver transplantation includes all causes of end-stage liver disease. All liver transplant candidates receive MELD score to reflect the disease severity or the risk of 3 months mortality without access to transplant. However, for some patients, the need for liver transplant is not based on the degree of liver dysfunction due to the underlying liver disease, but rather a complication of the liver disease. So, MELD exception points may be granted for patients whose mortality is believed to be greater than the indicated by MELD score, or for patients who are at risk of a bad outcome other than mortality. This is the list of indications for liver transplantation. We notice that the first and second category are the categories of liver failure, even acute fulminant failure or complication of cirrhosis as a chronic failure. The third and fourth categories are the categories that is associated with preserved synthetic liver function, I mean no liver failure. And again, this is the classification of indication of liver transplantation. We have liver cell failure, even acute or chronic, liver malignancy, systemic complications of chronic liver disease, or liver-based metabolic conditions causing systemic disease. The first category is liver failure, and the other three categories are the non-liver failure indications for liver transplantation. Now, we will not talk about the liver failure indication. We will talk about the non-liver failure indications for liver transplantation. First, the liver tumors. Liver transplantation in hepatocellular carcinoma, HCC is the most common primary tumor of the liver. Milan criteria remain the benchmark for selection of patients for liver transplantation. EASL clinical practice guidelines in 2016, liver transplantation for HCC patients meeting the Milan criteria has an excellent outcome, and expansion of these criteria is acceptable if the recurrence-free survival is comparable. All new models should be compared to Milan criteria. The second hepatic tumor that may need liver transplant is hepatic epithelioid hemangioendothelioma. When unresectable, and this must be, the diagnosis must be established by biopsy, not a single lesion amenable for resection. The second item is neuroendocrine tumor. When you resect the primary malignancy and any extrahepatic disease without any evidence of recurrence at least 6 months, you can proceed for liver transplant if you have liver metastasis, if you have neuroendocrine liver metastasis, but limited to the liver, bipolar, not amenable to resection, and the tumor metastatic replacement should not exceed 50% of the total liver volume. Hepatic adenoma. Hepatic adenoma is amenable for liver transplant if there is a risk of malignant transformation proven by biopsy. So, to summarize liver transplant in liver tumors, liver transplant is indicated in HCC within Milan criteria or within extended Milan criteria UCSF or after downstaging. Liver transplant is indicated in unresectable epithelioid hemangioendothelioma liver transplant is indicated in neuroendocrine tumor after removal of the primary and in adenoma with suspected malignant transformation. The second category for non-liver failure indications of liver transplantation, systemic complications of chronic liver disease. Hepatopulmonary syndrome is one of the most important indications. Hepatopulmonary syndrome is the presence of arterial deoxygenation and the pulmonary vasodilatation in patients with chronic liver disease. Severity of the disease is evaluated by ABG, arterial blood gases, and the echo with estimation of shunt fraction through a technetium labeled macroaggregated albumin scan. Mild exception is offered to this patient when oxygen saturation below 60 millimeter mercury on room air without underlying lung disease. Portopulmonary hypertension. Median pulmonary artery pressure when became above 25 millimeter mercury with elevated pulmonary vascular resistance above 240 with normal pulmonary capillary wedge pressure. This disease is classified to mild, moderate, and severe according to the pressure in pulmonary artery. Mild and moderate portopulmonary hypertension are candidate for liver transplantation. Mild disease, when the pressure is from 25 to 34, and moderate, when the pressure in the pulmonary artery is 35 to 44, provided that pulmonary vascular resistance is below 250. While severe portopulmonary hypertension is a contraindication for liver transplantation. The third category for non-liver failure indication in liver transplant are the liver-based metabolic conditions causing systemic disease. All of us know that we have metabolic liver diseases causing liver cell failure and are indicated, of course, for transplant as Wilson disease, hemochromatosis, alpha-1 and trypsin, ATC. But we have other metabolic disorders which affect extrahepatic organs while the synthetic liver function is not affected, like type 1 hyperoxaluria, familial amyloidosis, and in children, urea cycle defects, Krigler-Najjar syndrome, tyrosinemia, and cystic fibrosis. From these diseases, we will discuss two important diseases, which are type 1 primary hyperoxaluria, which is characterized by overproduction of oxalate with recurrent urolithiasis and progressive nephrocalcinosis, commonly leading to end-stage renal disease by the age of 20 to 40. Medical treatment may be effective in 30% of patients who discovered early by normalizing oxalate secretion and may prevent progression of disease if given early. While simultaneous liver kidney transplant is indicated, is needed, ideally before the point of no return, regarding the kidney functions, before need of dialysis. Familial amyloid polyneuropathy. This disease is associated with transthyretin gene mutation, resulting in progressive and disabling neurological condition. The vast majority of transthyretin is produced by the liver, so the only potentially curative treatment is liver transplantation. Liver transplant is indicated to eliminate hepatic amyloid production early in the course of the disease before development of ocular or cardiac manifestation, as if they develop, they are not reversible after transplant. We have also miscellaneous non-liver failure indications for liver transplant as refractory ascites, which has the 5 to 10% with portal hypertension defined by an international ascites club and has a 1 year mortality of nearly 50%. Hyponatremia is common in patients with cirrhosis and refractory ascites from portal hypertension. In January 2016, MELD score with sodium is implemented, incorporating sodium to the MELD score in cases of refractory ascites. Another category of patients that may need liver transplant even with liver functions accepted, persistent and intolerable pruritus, intractable pruritus is encholestatic liver disease as primary biliary cirrhosis, primary sclerosing cholangitis. After therapeutic trial, after failure of medical treatment, if pruritus is still persistent, you can proceed for liver transplant in spite of accepted synthetic liver function. Pruritus may lead to impairment of quality of life, prolonged wound healing, skin infections, and sleep disturbance, but you must exclude psychic element of exaggerating itching. This is a recommendation of EASI regarding primary biliary cirrhosis. They stated that in patients of refractory and intractable pruritus, they are indicated for liver transplantation. Recurrent cholangitis. Recurrent cholangitis requiring repeated drainage procedure as the endoscopic percutaneous in patients with cholestatic liver disease is also another indication for liver transplantation. And this is also in the guidelines of EASL 2016, when they stated that repeated episodes of cholangitis should be indication for liver transplantation. Polycystic liver disease. Polycystic liver disease combined with or without kidney disease with complication in these polycystic disease as hemorrhage, infection, pain, massive cystic enlargement, biliary obstruction, and rarely malignant transformation are indications of liver transplantation. Even these patients might have will be reserved synthetic liver function. So finally, conclusion and home messages. Liver transplantation is the only option for end-stage liver disease with manifestation of liver cell failure assessed by MELD score. However, some patients might have well-preserved synthetic liver function, but actually they need liver transplant for a reason rather than liver cell failure. MELD exception points are to award to those patients whose severity of illness and risk of complications are not captured by MELD score. In HCC, liver transplant is the ideal treatment. Milan criteria remain the cornerstone to select candidates for liver transplant. All new models of expansion should be compared with Milan criteria. Liver transplant is indicated also in some other liver tumors with specific consideration, as we mentioned, as unresectable adenoma and hepatic hemangioendothelioma. Liver transplant is indicated in hepatopulmonary syndrome when oxygen saturation is below 60%, 60 millimeter mercury in room air without underlying lung disease. Liver transplant is indicated in portopulmonary hypertension, mild to moderate disease, while mean pulmonary artery pressure is below 45 millimeter mercury and pulmonary vascular resistance below 250. In primary hyperoxaluria, simultaneous liver kidney transplant is indicated before point of end-stage renal disease. In familial amyloid polyneuropathy, liver transplant is also indicated in early cases before development of ocular or cardiac manifestations. Liver transplant is indicated in refractory ascites, in intractable pruritus not relieved by medical treatment, in recurrent cholangitis requiring repeated drainage, in polycystic liver disease with complications as infection, hemorrhage, biliary obstruction, malignant transformation. And finally, thank you.